The Math Center presents Solving Proportions. In this presentation, we'll answer the question, what is a proportion? Then we'll talk about solving proportions and look at an application of proportions. A proportion is a comparison between two fractions. Two fractions are said to be proportional if you get the same number when you cross multiply. Another way to think about this is that two fractions are proportional to each other if they are equal. Let's look at some examples. To determine if two fractions are proportional, we are going to cross multiply and compare the results. We are going to check to see if 1/2 is proportional to 3/6. Start by multiplying diagonally, which means the top of the left fraction multiplied by the bottom of the right fraction. This gives us 1 times 6, which equals 6. Now we'll do the other diagonal, which is the bottom of the left fraction multiplied by the top of the right fraction. This gives us 3 times 2, which is also 6. Since 6 is equal to 6, we would say yes, these two fractions are proportional. This also tells us that these fractions are equal to each other. If you reduce 3/6 by dividing the top and bottom by 3, you get 1/2. Here's another example. We want to check if 2/3 is proportional to 4/9. Again, we'll cross multiply and compare the results. Start by multiplying the top left by the bottom right, which gives us 2 times 9, or 18. Now we multiply the other diagonal, which gives us 3 times 4, which is 12. Notice that 18 and 12 are not equal, so these fractions are not proportional. How do we solve a proportion if we're missing a piece of the fraction? The key again is to cross multiply. In this example, we have two fractions that are in proportion. How do we know? Because they are equal to each other. The fraction on the right has a missing quantity. We know they are proportional, so we cross multiply. The results are equal to each other. 2 times x gives us 2x. And 7 times 3 gives us 21. These should be equal to each other, so we have 2x equals 21. To solve for x, we divide both sides by 2. This leaves us with just x on the left side and 21/2 on the other side. 21/2 is equal to 10.5, so x is equal to 10.5. There are many situations in real life where two quantities are proportional. In order to solve a word problem dealing with proportions, you first need to set up a proportion that you know. It always helps to label the proportion to keep track of the ratio you're using. Next, we'll set up the other side of the proportion, which will include some unknown quantity. Once you have set it up, you'll cross-multiply to solve for the unknown. Okay, let's work a tasty example. We're going to help Jill make some cookies. She has a recipe for cookies that calls for 2.5 cups of sugar and makes 12 cookies. As anyone will tell you, 12 aren't nearly enough, so she decides to make 30 cookies instead. How much sugar will she need? Let's start by making a proportion with the information we know. We'll put the amount of sugar on top and the number of cookies on the bottom. We know that for every 2.5 cups of sugar, we get 12 cookies. That's a lot of sugar for 12 cookies, but we'll assume that Jill knows what she's doing. So our fraction looks like this: 2.5 cups of sugar over 12 cookies. Now we'll fill in the other side of the proportion. We know how many cookies we want, so on the bottom of the right side, we'll put 30 cookies. Notice that cookies stay on the bottom of each fraction, and sugar is on the top. We don't know how much sugar we'll need, so our unknown is on the top, and we'll call it x. Once we have the proportion set up, we'll follow the steps as in the previous examples. Cross multiply to get 2.5 times 30 is equal to 12 times x. 2.5 times 30 is 75. So our equation is 75 equals 12x. Divide both sides by 12 and we end up with x equals 6.25. We'll need 6.25 cups of sugar. Thank you for watching this presentation on solving proportions.